interest of time, let me hand over straight away to Onewelt Chairman and Finnair CEO Pekka.
Thank you, Michael. Ladies and gentlemen, this year marked the 20th anniversary of Onewelt's conception. It was back in 1998 that American Airlines, British Airways, Cathay Pacific, and Qantas, all present up here now, announced the formation of the Alliance. My own Finnair was fast to recognize the great opportunity Onewelt presented in terms of added value for our customers and for our airline. We became the first recruit to sign up to join within months of Onewelt's launch in early 1999. Since then, many other of the world's airlines have followed us on board. So today, as you have seen and heard, Onewelt comprises of 13 of the industry's biggest and best, plus around 30 of our affiliated carriers. Elsewhere in the industry, others too recognize the advantages flowing from being a part of global alliance. Today, of the industry's 20 biggest network airlines, all but two are now members of one of the three global alliances. If you spread the net a little wider and look at the world's 50 biggest network airlines, you'll find there are fewer than 20% of them currently unaligned. It should be of little surprise then that the airlines in three global alliances today account for some 60% of total industry's capacity and revenues. Onewelt's core target market is travel between the world's leading business cities. In this important and growing market, the share of the three global alliances is still high, at some 70%. In this particular ring, Onewelt punches well above its weight. We have a global share of almost a quarter, which makes us the second largest alliance on this measure. Our focus on quality since the very start means that our lineup has to be the most attractive in the skies. That is reflected not just in that market share figure, but also by our performance in the various industry awards meetings. We can all be proud of Onewelt holds twice as many best airline alliance trophies than the other two alliances combined. And our network has to be one of the most attractive too, serving more than 1,000 destinations in 150 plus territories. For airlines and customers, that network is the biggest benefit Onewelt offers. By linking our individual airline networks together, we provide connectivity on a truly global basis. For our customers, it makes it easier and more rewarding to reach virtually anywhere on the planet. For us airlines, it translates into more revenues, particularly interline revenues from those connecting passengers. Since Onewelt was born, those interline revenues across the alliance have grown twice as fast as our overall passenger revenues, standing now at more than $5 billion a year, which, if it was an airline in its own, would make it one of the world's 30th largest. Now, with most of the world's biggest airlines already signed up to the global alliances, as I said earlier, global alliances have reached a maturity. Growth prospects are limited, certainly, in terms of traditional membership numbers. All the same, there are still parts of the world where we are at Onewelt would like to increase our presence further, and where our customers would like to extend our network. But there are only few airlines available, if you go by the past requirements for potential candidates. So how do we achieve the growth we want to have? It means we have to adapt. If we are going to achieve presence in some markets, we have to find a way of linking up with new partners who might not in the past have been considered candidates for Onewelt membership because of several reasons. Their networks are relevant only to a subset of established members, or they cannot necessarily meet Oneworld's full membership requirement at this stage, or they may not simply be interested in full membership at present, which is why today we are announcing Oneworld's first membership platform in our two decades of history, Oneworld Connect. In the future, we expect most of the membership growth to come via Oneworld Connect. Today, we are delighted to announce the first airline to join us in that capacity, Fiji Airways. More about that in a moment. We are progressing discussions with other airlines who are interested in signing for the program from various parts of the world, including Americas, Asia-Pacific, and Europe. Oneworld Connect provides a way of enhancing relationships between these new partners and Oneworld and its member airlines going forward, with a streamlined and rapid path to full membership later on, where that makes sense for all parties. Most importantly, it enables us and the partners who will join us in this capacity to offer our customers more services and benefits across an even wider network, strengthening our competitive position still further. Which is my cue to hand over this to Rob to explain Oneworld Connect's customer value proposition.
Thank you very much, Pekka, and let me add my words of welcome. It's great to see everybody here and a lot of familiar faces. It's nice to be back in my hometown, Pacific, so thank you. So since Oneworld was launched, we've offered a customer value proposition that extends across each and every airline and every airline you're flying with. Things like through check-in, customer support, throughout the network, the ability to earn a being 65 miles across all times, as well as status credits. And in fact, those frequent flyer benefits are extended across every one we're carrying, including lounge access, priority check-in, boarding, baggage, customs, and so on. But the essence of that is that it's dependent on total reciprocity between all of the member airlines. So each time you've added a new recruit, which has added network coverage to all established partners, it's been at a scale that makes that investment worthwhile and extending those service benefits to its own customers. And as Pekka has indicated, the pool in which we're fishing now in terms of potential new carriers that sort of fulfill that description is quite limited. What Oneworld Connect enables us to do is bring other airlines into the Oneworld family, airlines that don't meet our sort of historical or more legacy membership requirements. And that does require a different type of value proposition. So the Oneworld Connect partners will offer actually a subset of Oneworld's regular full range of customer service benefits. They'll provide a standard subset of alliance benefits to frequent flyers from any Oneworld member airline traveling on their flights. But in addition, a more extensive range of benefits will be offered within a subset of the Oneworld member airlines, which we are calling the Connect Carriers to Oneworld sponsors. And of course, as Michael said, those sponsors are sitting here up on the podium today. As you will see on the left column of that chart, customers with Emerald, Sapphire, or Ruby status in any Oneworld member airline's loyalty scheme will be able to use priority check-in desks when available when flying on any Oneworld Connect partner. And those with Emerald and Sapphire status in any Oneworld member airline's frequent flyer program will also be able to take advantage of priority boarding when available when flying on any Oneworld Connect partner. The additional benefits offered by Oneworld Connect partners to customers from their Oneworld sponsors and vice versa, you will see in the right-hand column. And they include through checking the passengers and their baggage for journeys, including connections between the Connect carrier and any of its Oneworld sponsors. The ability to earn and redeem frequent flyer rewards, earn frequent flyer status points for eligible flights. For customers from Oneworld Connect Airlines, those benefits depend on the Oneworld Connect partner offering frequent flyer programs and access to select lounges at key airports for first or business class passengers or those with top tier frequent flyer status. Selected other customer benefits may also be offered between Oneworld Connect partners and then Oneworld sponsor airlines on a bilateral basis. But let me stress that the current suite of standard Oneworld services and benefits from my new place of customers traveling on all long-haul full member airlines. To make it clear to customers which airline offers which suite of benefits, we are introducing this distinct OneWorld Connect sub-brand logo that will be displayed by OneWorld Connect pilots alongside their own logos as part of their signage, on their aircraft, and on their staff uniform badges. So what sort of companies are we considering as potential OneWorld Connect candidates? Well, PAC's already covered this to a degree. We do have some basic requirements. First of all OneWorld Connect airlines will be required to maintain IOSA safety certification. Secondly, each OneWorld Connect partner will need to have a minimum of 3 OneWorld sponsor members to be initiated into the program. As the lineup on the stage suggests, PGO is a quartet of sponsors, all of which, as Michael has said, are OneWorld's founding member airlines, American Airlines, British Airways, Cathay Pacific, and Qantas. Third, Canada Airlines will have to be able to deliver consistent OneWorld Connect products, services, and benefits just about outlined. And fourth, they'll need to make their networks available for the Global Explorer and OneWorld fare products offered by all OneWorld vendors and select other airlines. And that's basically it. The program is designed to be as flexible as possible for potential candidate airlines. And as Pekka has mentioned, with OneWorld approaching its 20th birthday, in the 2 decades since its inception, the industry and consumer behaviors have changed fundamentally. Most of our members have undergone significant and comprehensive transformation, some on multiple occasions. So 20 years ago, hardly any airline offered online bookings, let alone check-in. Ancillaries hadn't been invented. The likes of Emirates and Ryanair, well, let me put it this way, it's still in their infancy. Global alliances have to be really blunt about it, able to keep up with this pace, and we haven't. So at OneWorld, we're making up for that through OneWorld Connect, which is an entirely new program and platform, through new brand positioning, which we'll be talking about in the very near future, and through exciting digital products that, again, we'll be rolling out very soon, through new ways of working internally and through a host of other initiatives. But today is about OneWorld Connect, and now to introduce formally the very first OneWorld Connect partner, as CEO of the airline mentoring through its implementation. Please let me hand over to Boss now.
Thanks, Rob.
Are you here with us?
Yeah. Can I welcome everybody to Sydney, first of all? We're really pleased to hear, and this is a very exciting announcement for Andre and our friends from Fiji Airways. A little bit of history for those that don't know. Qantas and Fiji Airways go back a long time. Believe it or not, it was an Australian that helped set up the airline back in the 1950s. And Qantas became a shareholder in 1958, and we've had a very strong relationship with the airline ever since. We have a co-chairing partnership with Fiji Airways at the moment, and for a number of reasons, we're really excited about this partnership. First of all, our friends will add great value to the OneWorld network. It gives a destination that we think a lot of our customers around the globe want to actually travel to. Secondly, it really builds on what we're seeing as amazing demand from Australia, as an example. In the last year alone, we've brought an extra over 200,000 passengers, or 24% on Fiji Airways services. And there's huge demand here in this market. We know Australians have a love affair with Fiji, and we think this will help build that and create love affairs for airlines all over the globe. We're also seeing some amazing investments taking place at Fiji. Land Walker has set up an amazing resort, and for premium leisure travel in particular, this is an amazing destination to visit. And having these seamless opportunities for people to get to those destinations, we think is going to be great. So we're very, very happy to be a sponsor. We're our partners. We're a company we have a shareholding in. We're a company that we've worked with for 60 years. And we wish you all the best, and you all do very well out of OneWorld Connect, and OneWorld will do very well of having you as a partner. Can I pass on to Doug, who's going to say...
Like Qantas, American already has an established co-chair relationship with Fiji, and we're excited
to now bring Fiji Airways in as a One World Connect partner that will allow our customers to have even better access to the South Pacific and make the South Pacific even more attractive than it already is for our customers. And it'll allow the Fiji Airways customers, of course, the ability to travel to and across North America much smoother and easier. So welcome, we're glad you're here.
Thank you, Doug. As Rob Gurney has said, the global alliances will need to continue to evolve if they are to remain relevant in this fast changing industry, and that's exactly what One World is doing today. British Airways, as you know, along with my colleagues here, was one of the launch partners of One World, and we're delighted to support this initiative. We're excited about the opportunity to work with Fiji Airways. We're looking forward to developing closer links with one another for the benefit of both of our airlines, the benefit of our customers, and for the benefit of the wider One World community. So I'm joined with my colleagues and welcome Fiji Airways today.
Thank you, Willie, and I would endorse that. Cathay Pacific has always been very proud of its part in the formation of One World 20 years ago and making it, I think, one of the leading quality alliances that it is today. And we're equally proud to be supporting this exciting new membership platform, One World Connect, and getting it off the ground today, and doing that as a sponsor of Fiji Airways, our long-term co-chair partner. I would endorse everything that's been said. It's a fabulous destination, and I think this additional connectivity will really play well for everyone concerned. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Rupert. So we're going to hear in just a minute from Andre, and then we'll follow that with a Q&A session. We'll use these mics to
colleagues, as we say in Fiji, voila! Good afternoon. Fiji's national airline, is thrilled and honored to be the first One World Connect partner globally. We are delighted to be linking with the world's premier airline alliance and deepening our relationships, in particular with our sponsors, Qantas, American Airlines, British Airways, and Cathay Pacific. I would like to thank the teams at One World, our sponsors, and the wider One World family, and indeed, the team involved at Fiji Airways for all the support they have provided us to enable to reach this important landmark for our airline today. Our accession into One World as a One World Connect member enables us to offer more services and benefits to our own customers along with the others in the One World family, to achieve a greater presence for our airline internationally and to build on the inbound tourism that is so vital to our home nation. It is also a matter of great pride for us at Fiji Airways to link the South Pacific to the One World network. In effect, one of the world's final frontiers for travel is now connected. For those of you unfamiliar with Fiji Airways, a few facts and figures. Founded in 1951, we today serve 21 destinations in 13 states and territories, including several One World hubs. I understand we will now be adding 7 additional territories to the One World network, including our home Fiji. Our regional subsidiary Fiji Link serves a further 9 destinations across our Fijian and neighbouring Pacific Islands. We operate a fleet of 18 aircraft, including 5 Airbus A330s, with a 6 that will join our fleet shortly, and 5 next-generation Boeing 737s. We offer a 2-class business and economy product on most international routes, including seats that convert to an angle lie-flat bed. I'm proud to state as well that Fiji Airways will be the first airline in the region to receive and operate the brand new Boeing 737 MAX 8 on our short and medium haul routes from December, offering an excellent cabin experience with modern in-flight amenities for our guests. Last year, we boarded 1.6 million customers, generating revenues of US$452 million and profits of US$44 million. At the operating level and 38 million at the net level. A picture is worth 1,000 words, they say, So I'm happy to let the short video introduce Fiji Airways, Fiji's national.